Hi, I'm Nicholas Ross, Chief Strategy Officer with Financial Independence Group. It's a good idea regularly to assess the value provided by your IMO BGA. Ask yourself questions such as, are you receiving the value that you expect from your relationship? There's usually something left on the table that requires more of an in-depth look to examine that relationship and find out if it's truly profitable for you near term and a relationship that you should maintain long term. First is making sure that you're able to include all major areas of interest for your client's financial and estate planning needs. That's care planning insurance, it's Medicare planning, disability income, and even more bespoke planning opportunities such as property and casualty. The second area that's a necessity inside of your firm today is making sure that you have the vast array of carrier or manufacturer products available. For example, if you find yourself utilizing 1, 2, 3 vendors specifically with most financial planning scenarios, you may want to examine what else may be out there from a competitive landscape to ensure that your clientele are not going outside of you. We all know in every relationship, communication is king. What are you currently getting out of your communication with your existing IMO BGA partnership? Is it reactive, or is it also a combination to include proactive communication to make sure that you are armed and informed with what's happening on the street today? One of the greatest areas of interest for IMO BGA partnerships that should be provided to you is a continual track for training, advancement, education in all areas of people, processes, business development, and expansion for your business hereafter. If anything that was said today is of interest to you or is not being currently utilized inside your firm, I challenge you to reach out to Financial Independence Group to talk about customization of those areas of interest and talk about what that may look like for your business in the future.